I'm going to talk to you today about PodCamp because I thought what better place to talk about an event that starts with P and has a weird name than Pecha Kucha. PodCamp is a national brand. It started in Boston in 2005, and now it's an event based on social media that happens all over the world. It is designed for newbies as well as advanced users. And the first rule of PodCamp is please talk about PodCamp. We're stuck with this name, so we need all the help we can get. There is a PodCamp Western Mass, and as of this year, we became the longest running PodCamp in New England. We, the last few years, have been based in Holyoke, but we have members from all four counties of Western Mass. And there are PodCamp veterans in the crowd today. I can see them. No one is safe at PodCamp. It's very important to remember this. It is a social media boot camp, if you will. It's an annual event, happens once a year. And you are encouraged to bring your laptops, your phones, your earbuds, your tablets, and even a piece of paper and a pen, if you'd like. So you are not safe, and you have to untag yourself later. Your picture will be taken at PodCamp. You will listen, not because you have to, not because we're going to force you, because you want to. You want to. There are several different sessions at PodCamp throughout the day, about an 8-hour day, and tons of sessions, but also great conversations happening at lunch and during the coffee breaks and in the hallways. You'll also talk, and you don't have to talk in front of a million people. If you're an introvert and you'd rather just do more listening or talk to people one-on-one, that's fine. PodCamp is designed for extroverts as well as introverts. This is actually the introverts meet extroverts session that happened in March this year. And you will document, this goes back to the first rule of PodCamp, which is you must talk about PodCamp and that you are not safe at PodCamp. At PodCamp, we'll see that everyone is tweeting and Facebooking and taking pictures, and like I said before, even has a pad and paper if you're willing to go that route. But there is documentation everywhere, and it's how we publicize ourselves. The event publicizes itself before, during, and after. And again, like I said, with a name like PodCamp, that's what we need. You will embrace technology. This is me with a robotic hand. I found out what it sounds like when I flip somebody off 2 years ago at PodCamp. I didn't flip anybody specific off, but I did find out what that sounds like. And that was just one of many technology-based sessions that you can attend at PodCamp. In addition to technology, you must embrace the giant sticky notes, and this is very important. Not only is that just totally pretty, I think, but an agenda doesn't exist at PodCamp when you get there. It's an example of an unconference. So there's no agenda. You say what you want to hear about, and conversely, other people say what they want to talk about, and the agenda is created with the giant sticky notes. They're also really great for a million other things. If you've ever, just go buy giant sticky notes. They're so helpful. You will use the law of 2 feet. This is one of the most important rules of PodCamp, is not rude to walk out on somebody's session if it's under your head or over your head, or you wanted to see another one that was going on in the same time slot. It's not rude. You can get up and move. You'll meet interesting people. I think I'm showing my age with that Bugs Bunny reference, that joke. But you do meet interesting people, and I'm not just talking about authors like Steve Garfield, who wrote Get Seen, which is a book that's really great about learning how to use video to promote yourself and your business. But there are all different types of folks. It's not just people like me. It's not just students. I don't know what a person like me is. Trust me. I don't know. But for people like me, students, managers, business owners, et cetera, it will probably snow. It's very important for me to mention this because 4 out of 5 PodCamp Western Mass, it has snowed. But one of the most important concepts around PodCamp is that it's local and it's designed to be simple and easy. So it's in Western Mass. It's not your New England PodCamp where you have to go to Portland, Maine. At some point during the day, you will feel like a genius. There's a lot of people talking about a lot of the same things, and you'll know the answer to questions, and you'll suddenly feel like Nostradamus. Unfortunately, you will also feel like a moron at some point in the day. Someone is going to have a cooler iPhone than you. Someone will have a better tablet, and someone is going to know a lot more about Facebook or Twitter or Pinterest than you. But there are those moments when you have those genius seconds, so just hold on. It's going to be all right. We all feel stupid at the same moment. That woman, by the way, is not a moron. There will be coffee at PodCamp. No matter what the setup is, we will make sure we have coffee. That was our setup, our first PodCamp in 2009. That's my coffee maker. And it's plugged into the floor, and I had a lot of surly PodCampers that year. So the next year, we went to Box of Joe, and this year, we had lovely Holyoke Community College set up. We even had decaf there. I don't know why anybody needs decaf, but we're getting better every year, is my point. You will be nice to the guy with the three-cornered cap because his name is Steve Sherlock and he's been involved with the PodCamp movement since the very beginning. He was at the very first PodCamp that ever existed in 2005 in Boston, hence the three-cornered cap. And he comes and helps out at ours every year and literally shows people where to go and what to do. And he's a nice guy. You will have lunch at PodCamp. That is one of the most important sessions of the day because that's when people tell me that that's when they've had some of the best conversations. They've met people that they've only known online or through their Twitter handle or maybe on Facebook through a friend of a friend. And not to mention everybody loves lunch at a conference. So we've decided that even if we're going to keep the cost down and we keep it low, we keep it around $20, but we're always going to feed you. And you will wear your pithy interactive t-shirt. We were very proud of ourselves in 2009 to be one of the first nonprofit organizations to ever use the QR code on a t-shirt. It's not as, you know, it's a little more commonplace now. So now we have a little bit more fun with what we write on the back of the shirt. This is Morris and Leslie. They met at the very first PodCamp Western Mass in 2009, and they're still together today. Morris is my co-founder of PodCamp Western Mass, me and another woman named Kelly Galanis. And Leslie Lambert has been involved as an organizer ever since. And to go on trips together, they go to other PodCamps around the country. And together, they have been to 32 in the last 5 years. And you will please tolerate shit PodCampers say, pardon my language. It goes back to the genius moron thing. You know, we're all feeling like we're part of this zeitgeist and we're feeling very smart and wonderful. And all of a sudden, we have a lot of really important things to say and tweet. Like, politicians should be banned from making hashtags. And finally, you will attend the after party, just like lunch and coffee. We always have an after party. This year, it was at a place called Slancha in Holyoke. And this, again, is where you go and you meet all your friends and you take stupid selfies like this and show them later at an event that also begins with P and has a weird name. If you'd like to check us out, you can check us out at podcamp.westernma.biz or hashtag PCWM on Twitter. Thanks.